Happy New Year's Eve, everyone. This is Chrissy D. And today is weigh-in time. And I weighed in already. And I'm 263. Yay. Feeling pretty good about that. Oh, I was kind of skeptical. You remember yesterday I was talking about how I gained the 3 pounds, so I lost 2, so I'm really excited. I would have showed you guys, but as you know, with my lighting in my apartment, it sucks. So even when I put the camera down to show you guys the scale, you can't really see it. But I promise you guys, this morning when I woke up, I weighed in at 263. So I'm excited about that. I've eaten already, so I'll probably put back on a pound or two, who knows. But I didn't eat much. I just ate like a handful of rice and some tuna. I really don't have an appetite lately. I really don't know what that's about. Like, to think about food is, I'm not gonna say it disgusts me, but it's like, ugh, you know, food. And I guess because I'm eating some of the same things, you know, on a regular basis, and maybe I should try to switch it up, you know, I don't know, but just not feeling food. I'm still keeping myself hydrated and all that stuff. Not too much has changed within the last 24 hours, but well, my clothes has changed, but not my hair. I hadn't done my hair, but anyways, I just wanted you guys to know what I weighed today. And I hope you guys are ecstatic, because I am, and I look forward to seeing you guys' video and your weigh-in and the things that you're talking about. I'm sorry, y'all. I ate, and it's like my food get caught like right up in here, and it's like it won't digest. It is so uncomfortable for me. Like, it's so uncomfortable for me. Like, sometimes I feel like I should. And I don't mean to be so graphic, but I feel like I should stick my finger down my throat and make myself regurgitate everything, because it just feels so awful. A friend of mine said that it may be acid reflux. I don't know, so maybe I should get some Tums or Prilosec or Zantac, something around in there to help me out with that. But then again, it could be the rice. You know, I've been eating rice for the past few days or whatever. Not much rice, but enough to, rice gets me full, like, and it keeps me full all day long, and I only eat once a day, and I ate early, so I'll probably eat no more till tomorrow. And it's not because, you know, I'm trying to starve myself or anything. It's like, when I eat rice, I don't have an appetite. I don't know what that's about, but I'm still using my little square plate or whatever. It's about, I want to say, 3.5 inches wide and like maybe 6 or 7 inches long. It's not big at all. Just, you know, enough for me to keep my portion control, because if I eat on a big plate, I'm going to eat a lot. I mean, I'm just, you know, because people hadn't really got that concept yet, you know. And it, you know, the whole plate size thing, it really does help with your weight loss, you know, and your journey, and actually letting you see how much you should really eat. But, I'm sorry, y'all, this is a boring video. I'm halfway sleepy, you know. I got my nephew, my nephew, he's a newborn, so I get him early, and I'm with him maybe 11 hours out of a day, so I'm a little bit sleep deprived. Very sleep deprived, actually. But I'm just trying to check in with you guys and to let you know what's going on. And y'all, I'm really excited. I'm actually very hopeful now. Hopefully within the next week or week and a half, I hope to God that I'm in a new bracket of numbers. It's crazy. Like, I want this so bad, and it's so frustrating, especially when you're right there at the brink of it. Like, ugh, it's so frustrating. And but I'm gonna get there. I'm gonna get there no matter what. I am. And it's not like, I want to lose an enormous amount of weight because, you know, I've said this before, you know, I just want to lose probably about 40 to 50 more pounds. You know what I mean? Like, I actually like the whole, the thick look, you know what I mean? I just got fat. I'm fat now. I don't care how you put it, this and that and the other. Your girl has gotten fat. And I just want to be in a thick stage again. Like, back when I was, like, 210, 215, like, I have one of those body types, like, I have an hourglass shape. Now, don't get me wrong. Like, when I gained my weight, I gained it all in the right places. You know, I don't look nasty or anything or nothing like that. Or I'm not, like, flubber or nothing like that. But, you know, it's just, it's just too much. Needless to say, it's just too much. It's too much in the right areas, pretty much. And I just want to get back to the way, you know, I was before I started having children. You know, I was tight. I was right, not saying that my body is ever going to be the same, because I don't know what the hell it is about having children. Your body never goes back to the way it was. It might look like it, but it never really goes back to the way it was. But I just want to be, that's at that point, and, you know, not even that. Let's see. I have a picture, and I'm going to show you. Sorry if it gets light, I don't have my light on. But there's a picture in here that I'm going to show you guys. Like, a couple of pictures of me before I had my second, before I had my second child. Let's see. And I was maybe, like, I want to say a couple weeks pregnant, I want to say. And I'll let you see it. I got so many pictures in this book, I'm sorry. Maybe you see these. Those are keloids. This right here, that's all from my thyroid surgery. And that's never going to go away. It's kind of annoying and kind of had me in a bad headspace for a minute because, you know, us women in scars, you're like, oh my god, I'm not pretty anymore. I'm so ugly. I got a scar. This net, yeah, I went through that. And I was like, man, my baby's not gonna touch me no more. He's not gonna kiss my neck no more. You know, my neck is that spot, but yeah, I was like, he's not gonna kiss my neck no more. He don't wanna touch me, this and that, the other. But he come around. Now, this is me. I don't know if I showed you guys, and I probably have, I'm not sure. But this is me when I was 16. That's me. Today? Hell no. Then? It's about 13 years ago. With Keel, and right there, I was pushing 200 pounds. That's me when I was 16. And I'll show you another picture. But, back to the whole scar issue. I was really subconscious about it. Like, after my surgery, like, it had me in a really bad headspace. Like, I couldn't talk, I couldn't sing, and nothing like that. And not to mention, I had this big old scar on my neck. Like, it was so horrible. But, you know, I have a loving husband, and he loves me for me. So, okay, this picture right here. And you can't see my face because it's just me showing off my 2.5-week-old belly because we just found out we were pregnant. But right here, I don't know if you can see that, but you see how small I was? And right there, I was 247 pounds. Right there. I don't know if you can see it, but right there. I didn't have a stomach, or nothing like that. I had nice legs. That was me. And I'm 263 now. So that's probably about like 15 more pounds. Somewhere around 15, 16 more pounds. And I was comfortable right there. But still, I could have, you know, I could have lost 20 more pounds. And that's what I want to get to, you know. That's what I want to do. And I'm going to do. So I just wanted, you know, to give you guys an idea of, you know, my body type and how I'm built and this and that and the other. My biggest area now is my tummy, and I think 99% of women have that issue, their tummy. They don't really care about nothing else. They just want their stomach to be flat or somewhat flat, you know. And I think society has a lot to do with that. Society has played a big part in our whole getting thin and this and any other. I'm not trying to be thin. I'm not trying to be a size 10. Hell, I'm not even trying to be a size 12. I want to be a size 14, 16. And that's just me. That's just me. You can bash me or whatever, but you know, I don't want to be thin. I don't want to be that small. You know, I really, really don't. I just, at that stage, and really and truly, when I was a 14, 16, I was in a two-piece and had a flat stomach. Like, you can't tell me anything. Like I said, it's just the way that I'm built. Like, my family, they are big-boned people, and they're tall. And, you know, my bloodline is white, black, Indian. Well, in the Indian part is Cherokee Indian and Navajo Indian. And, you know, do the research, they're pretty big-boned people. You know, but that's a little bit of my heritage, but that's just pretty much it. Like, I just want to get back comfortable in my own skin, and I'm starting to get there, but it's hard, but we all have that struggle. But I'm not going to keep you guys. I just want to let you know that I weighed in today, and it's 263 once again. Hopefully by this time next week, I'll lose another 3 pounds. Each week, my personal goal is going to be 3 pounds. So, but my goal is 3, but I'm pushing for 5, you know, so anywhere between 3 to 5 pounds. But that's pretty much it. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. I promise to be more upbeat next time. Just had a rough day, got up cleaning and taking care of babies and this and that and the other, so I'm a little bit tired, but I love you guys, and I hope to see you soon. And you know, keep smiling and keep pressing, and I hope you guys have a very awesome new year and live it to the fullest. If you got a loved one, grab them and hold them and kiss them and make love and whatever it is that you do to bring in the new year. Just don't do nothing stupid and land you in jail or dead. We don't want that. But just have fun, you guys, and be responsible, and I'll see you next time. Until then, hold on, because you can and will get through this. God bless.